Hi guys, welcome to another episode of All Over the Floor. Today we're going to be installing carpet. I don't do carpet very often, and hopefully I don't do it ever again. I got a friend, Travis, and we're going to go to his house and we're going to put some carpet in for him. So hopefully it's an informative video. If you're thinking about trying carpet yourself, I've done almost every flooring out there that you could possibly do, and I'm going to tell you that carpet is probably one of the hardest to do. It's not as easy as you would think. I used to watch carpet guys install carpet when I was first starting in tile, and I thought, oh man, that looks so easy. It is if it's plush or frisee, but when you get into all these different types of stairs with all the different types of wraps, and I mean, it can start to get complicated. Flat work, this is what we're doing today. I'll do flat work. It's the easiest thing. If you're going to try it yourself, I'd recommend going to Home Depot or Lowe's and renting your tools. I actually saw a how to make your own kicker video, which is the stupidest thing I've ever seen in my life. Guy took a bunch of 2x4s and put some nails in it and made his own kicker. And you can go to Harbor Freight and buy a really garbage cheap kicker for like 15 bucks. I think my kicker cost me about $79. And you could probably rent one from Home Depot for like 8 bucks for the day or something. But your best bet is to use a power stretcher. You want to power stretch everything in. If you hire and get cheap labor on your carpet, those guys are going to use kickers. And, a good power stretcher costs $300 to $1,200, depending on all the extra poles and adapters and deals that come with it, and the stinger tail and et cetera, and the speed pole. So a lot of these guys just have a kicker, maybe even a $15 kicker, and they're going to kick it in. And by not stretching it in real tight, what happens is that your carpet slumps all up and gets wrinkles in it, and it's going to need stretched in again, and you're going to have to pay somebody to come in and re-stretch your carpet. So if you hire somebody, make sure they're using a power stretcher. Unless it's stairs, they're going to be using a kicker. And closets also, they're just closets too small to fit in a power stretcher. You have to typically kick in a closet. So stick around. Hope it's a good video. Hope you guys like it. Make sure to hit that thumbs up button and make sure to subscribe to catch more of my videos.
The staples with a floor scraper, and we're about to throw down some pad, and then we'll kick out some carpet and we'll show you guys how to make a seam. Pad's all in. We're gonna kick out our carpet, and then unfortunately I was so busy throwing pad down, I didn't show you guys how to do it. It's pretty simple. Cut it into fit, staple it, cut the extra off, it overhangs the tack strip, tack it down with a pad tacker. It's pretty simple
stuff. I didn't get the seam make it on film, but you know, cut it straight with a straight edge, two pieces, butt them tight, heated up the tape, melted middle seam. If you see real close, we actually have a seam here and our seam's all the way here. I think I did a pretty good job. And Dan's trimming that in, so I'm gonna stretch away from this. I'm gonna do a relief cut right here. Relief cut right here. I don't know if you guys can see it because I got my head camera on and I'm trying to work. Peel it back and trim it. Push the carpet in right here with the carpet tool. Trim this little fella off. Put the carpet in, carpet tool. That little fell off. Carpet in with the carpet tool. Put a little mini relief cut here. Relief cut here. Rub that down so I can stretch away. A little bit of relief cut here. Relief cut it here. I'm gonna take my power stretcher. I'll give it a stretch. First of all, I'm gonna relief cut it because it's way past the tile and I can't even see where I'm stretching to. Oh, I'm only stretching to right here. So get all this stuff out of my way. Same thing for here, yep. Get it out of my way. Bada bing. Give it a real light stretch. I see a bubble popping up right here, so I'm gonna stretch it my way a little bit. Stretch and pin it. I'm gonna just give it a soft stretch just to pin it into the hook. There's my tack strip, so I'm gonna give it a soft stretch. Just push it right down into that tack strip and let it off. Now it should be pinned. Now I'm gonna push this stuff down and in. Now I'm gonna give it a good stretch across. Break that back loose, give it a good stretch. Pin it. I'm gonna leaf cut it right here off that corner so that it wants to sit down and stay pinned. I'm gonna leaf cut it. You want to stretch it an angle into the corners, but I got a bubble here, so I pretty much want to kind of stay straight to get that bubble out. There we go. I'm going to pin it. It's not wanting to go down, so again, I'm going to relief cut it here, and now pin it. Let off my stretch. This bubble is this way, meaning it'll come out when I stretch it the other direction. I'm gonna take, rub this down and pin it. All right, now this is all pretty well. I'm gonna set the rest of this. If it pops loose, it probably should be double tack stripped. If it pops loose, we're just gonna kick it back. All right, now I'm gonna stretch up to this corner. If you look, when I come back here, bubble's pretty much gone. I'm gonna pin it. Again, we're gonna relief cut it here. Now I got a good stretch on it. Set it. Now I'm gonna give a straight on stretch. Pin it. One more. Pin it. I'm gonna set this whole wall right here. Then this will be set. I'm gonna stretch back to here. We're gonna rub this wall down right here with my foot. And then I'm gonna stretch, stretch, stretch. Actually, I'll probably stretch the width because you want to stretch it first. I'll stretch, stretch, stretch to here and stop a little bit. And then I'll stretch the rest of this. And I'm basically taking and stretching all the carpet into this corner.
You people in TV land, I got it all stretched in. I'm going to show you how to trim it in. You're going to relief cut it all the way down, boop, right there. And then basically that gap is about an eighth of an inch from here to the wall. So I'm going to cut an eighth of an inch onto the carpet past that line. And then I'm gonna tuck it right down into the wall. Bada bing, bada boom. Pretty simple. I'm gonna keep tucking carpet. Here we go. They actually make a trimming tool that you can use, but I don't use it because I can almost hand trim it as fast as that trimmer. And I have a hard time dialing that trimmer in. I actually have one. I can trim it better, I believe. It always trims too short or too big with that hand trimmer, so I just trim it by hand. And if when you're trimming it, you get to a spot that's a little loose, you just bump it with your kicker or come back with your stretcher, stretch it back up a little bit.
All right, there we go. This room's all done. And this room's all done. I think I did a really good job on the seam. You can't see it. Seam is right there. Especially for not even being a carpet guy. And same thing in here in the master. It's all done. Closet's all stretched in. Whoop. And here's my seam right here. You can't even see my seam. Pretty darn good. All finished up. I wish I could have took more time to explain to you and show you guys better or what I was doing, but I was just trying to get done. I did this hardwood actually that we're walking on. Also, I installed this hardwood probably a year or so ago when they first bought the house. I actually installed all this tile in here. So I did this floor probably 3 years ago. I did that backsplash. And I did this little sink splash behind the sink. And then, oh, I like to show off the fact that, check out how my wood goes right up underneath. You see that seamless, where my wood hits the fireplace there? No quarter round. Most guys aren't professionals and can't pull something like that off. There's a lot of little tiny details that I noticed that other people don't notice. And then I was actually busy. My buddy Larry did this carpet on the steps because I was kind of busy and said, hey Larry, you want to do these steps for me? And I actually did all of this floating floor when Travis first moved in. Same thing, we got a nice tight seamless no quarter round right at the fireplace. And then I did this carpet in these bedrooms too when he first moved in. So you've got a bedroom and a bedroom of carpet and another room of carpet that I did probably 3 years ago. So I've almost done every single floor in this house. Hope you guys enjoyed this episode. Sorry that I was in such a hurry to get the work done. I didn't show a whole lot of what we were doing. When I get to laying carpet, I'm in wall work mode. So